Hey there guys, and welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy 13. In the last episode, we watched a whole bunch of scenes, and we ended up at the entrance to the Pulse Fal'Cie Vestige. And now we are in control of Vanille and Hope. So the first thing you're going to want to check out is the new shop, the B&W Outfitters, which is now available at the save point. Here you can buy iron bangles. So I will go ahead and equip Hope with the iron bangle because he has low HP. This will increase his HP a little bit because he has very, very low HP.
Doing here.
All right, so before you go up the stairs in front of you, go ahead and take this side path to the right, and you'll reach a dead end with a treasure ball. Containing 30 gil. Now go ahead and head up the stairs. You'll run into a bunch of enemies. Remember, you're gonna want to fight all the battles that you encounter so that you can level up and get stronger. I'll go more into detail later. After the battle, you get a Fortisol. Now, let me quickly explain about shrouds, which is what we just got, a Fortisol. At any time out of battle, you can press L1 or the left bumper, and that will pull up your shrouds list. Now, these are very important items because what they do is they cast certain magic effects on your party members before you fight. And they usually last for about a minute to 5 minutes. And it's very, very useful, especially if you're about to fight a boss. So what you would generally do is save them. And then when you're at a very hard fight, you press the left bumper right before you engage the enemy and click on each shroud, so that you can buff your characters up before you even enter the battle. That way, when you do enter, your characters will be fully buffed up and you can focus on primarily defeating the enemy instead of casting buffs on yourself. So these are very useful. And later on in this video, I'll show you guys how to obtain more, because you're gonna want to farm as many as you can and gather as many as you can and save them for later on in the game. So for now that you know what shrouds are and how to use them effectively, I suggest to save them all and go ahead and engage the next set of enemies directly in front of you. There's a Deceptazol, which is another shroud. You can check what each shroud does by clicking left bumper.
Please don't go looking for trouble.
Go ahead and open up the treasure ball that the enemies were guarding for 4 potions. Now take note that some treasure balls like this one will be guarded by enemies, and the only way to open them up is to defeat the enemies in front of it. So keep that in mind whenever you're searching for treasure balls. Go ahead and head over to the right side. Engage in more enemies.
Take this!
After you've cleared out all the enemies on this floor, go ahead and descend the stairs. Here you can get a short tutorial on how to preemptive strike enemies. So basically, preemptive strikes are where you catch the enemies off guard, allowing you to quickly stagger them and get an advantage in battle.
Where is he?
Not only are you able to strike first, but they're also very close to being staggered on a preemptive strike, allowing you to hit them once, stagger them, and then finish them off very quickly. So preemptive strikes are very, very useful. Now, how you do that is you're gonna wanna sneak up on an enemy, wait for the enemy to turn its back to you, and then run up and engage them. If you did it right, it should say preemptive strike at the start of the battle. So a quick example. As you can see, it's a preemptive strike. The Neil hits all the enemies and gets them very close to stagger.
Goodbye.
Allowing you to quickly take them all out. Go ahead and open up the treasure ball that they were guarding for another iron bangle. You can go ahead and save this one for another character if you wish to equip it to them. Head over to the right and jump over the debris into another area. Here you'll have to clear out a few more enemies. After taking them out, proceed to the destination marker, which is the orange exclamation mark circled on your map. Now, at any time while in the field, you can press the square or X button to pull up the main map. This will easily help you navigate.
Aren't you scared?
Not so much.
You really don't get it.
Pulse Fal'Cie and Lissie are bad news. That's why Cocoon kicked them out. Live too close to the Fal'Cie, one-way ticket to Pulse. That's the purge in a nutshell.
If they catch us here, they'll purge us too, and then...
What's your problem?
What's my... Pulse is hell on Earth.
We'll be okay. Calm down.
Get off me.
Sarah?
Huh?
Can you hear me? Where are you?
Don't worry, Sarah. Your hero is on his way. Wonder what that's for.
Alright, so the control will switch to Snow, who is also in the Pulse Fal'Cie vestige in search of his fiancée, Sarah. So the first thing you're going to want to do is turn around and head directly behind you to find a treasure ball with two potions inside. and that's the only treasure in this area. So go ahead and proceed to the destination marker. Go ahead and plow through the enemies in your way.
Nothing to worry about!
Go ahead and examine the lever.
Just hold on, Sarah.
Still won't budge? I think the door's winning.
Why didn't I listen?
Beg your pardon?
It was me. This is my fault.
Beg your pardon?
Cover your ears.
Huh? Oh, blast charge? Oh, wait, hold on. All right, hold on. All right, go for it! Make it happen!
I'm so sorry. Please let me in. Please?
Hey!
Right.
What? How'd you open it?
Well, after you.
So after the scenes, you'll be in control of Lightning and Saz. And here's where the Shrouds tutorial plays. Shows you how to use Shrouds effectively. There's a save point ahead if you want to save your game. Otherwise, advance forward and take out the next group of enemies. After you've disposed of them, go ahead and proceed upstairs. And there's a bunch of enemies in this area, so go ahead and clear them all out. Huh. up by the left side. Open up the treasure ball on the left for a tuft of Phoenix down.
This thing's some kind of welcoming present for that.
And then take out the remaining enemies on the right. Now there's one more enemy in this area, and he's the big robot that's blocking the path forward. Now a very easy way to do this is sneak up behind him. Oh, I couldn't sneak up, oh well. I'm gonna have to take him out head on. Strike this guy. So if you're having trouble defeating him, just try to sneak up and around him so that you can preemptive strike. You get a digital circuit for winning. Then proceed up the stairs that the Myrmidon was blocking. And at the top, you'll run into more enemies. After you dispose of them, open up the treasure ball on the left for the Gladius, a new weapon for lightning. So I highly suggest to equip that to her now because it raises up her strength, which is going to be useful for the battles ahead. At the top of the next set of stairs, you'll get another battle. Died right before I killed him. Wow. Oh well. After you take out the final
path, if those things are still around, might be some soldiers trapped in here too. Except they'd probably be Fal'Cie by now. Huh? Not even human anymore. Just post Fal'Cie. Enemies of Cocoon. Can't show him any mercy.
There's the next one.
After the scene, control will switch back to Snow. Just like before, check directly behind you for a treasure ball. And this contains two potions. This is the only treasure around here again. So go ahead and proceed to the destination marker afterwards. Here you'll have to dispatch another group of enemies.
Nothing to worry about! Just too easy!
Go ahead and examine the lever again to get things moving.
All right.
And then head up the stairs behind it and jump on the elevator.
Hang on, baby. Your hero's on the way.
He is here. Calling himself a hero.
He's coming our way.
What should I do?
Tell him what you need to.
But nothing I say will change what happened.
We could just run away.
All right, so you're back in control of Vanille and Hope. Go ahead and take out the enemies in front of you. Go ahead and ascend the stairs to your right, and then turn right again to reach an area with a treasure ball and more enemies. Go ahead and take out the enemies first, so that you can open up the treasure ball. After clearing the enemies, open up the treasure ball for a Fortizol shroud. And then turn around and head in the opposite direction. Then go ahead and enter the next area. Alright, so here you'll find a save point. Go ahead and save your game. And I'm going to give you guys a great tip that will help you out a lot in the future. If you return to the previous area that we just came from, all of the enemies will be respawned, allowing you to kill them again.
Do you know where we're going?
Now, you don't want to do this just to level up, but more importantly, these enemies will quite frequently drop shrouds, such as Fortisol and Agisol, or Fortisol and Deceptisol. This will allow you to stock up a good amount of shrouds early in the game. Because shrouds are very rare, you can find them, but it's kind of hard to get them later on in the game. So if you take about 15-20 minutes by returning to this area, clearing out all the enemies, you will gain shrouds. Like, see, we just got a Fortisol. Because the enemies in this area have a high chance to drop them. And the chance is even higher if you get a low battle rating. So remember, at the end of each battle, you're graded by stars. Well, if you get lower stars, meaning you prolong the battles, and you can do this very easily by just letting Hope attack. Don't attack with Vanille. Just let Hope attack and kill the enemies. This will let you get a lower battle rating. So the lower amount of stars you have at the end of each battle increases the rate of shrouds drop. So I would suggest to stock up about at least 5 Fortisols and 5 Deceptisols for the battle ahead, for a couple battles ahead actually, because this is a very great place to do that. Because like I said, shrouds are very rare, so when you do get them, you're going to want to make sure to hold on to them for tough battles ahead. And again, just have Vanille do nothing and have Hope kill off the enemies. This will lower your battle rating and allow and increase the chances of them dropping shrouds. So I always suggest to come back here and kill all the enemies about 4 or 5 times. You don't have to spend a whole lot of time doing it. See here, we got a Deceptisol. You don't have to spend a lot of time doing it because you're not really doing this for the experience. You're just mainly doing it for the shrouds. So just go ahead and let Hope take out the enemies. And it should take about 15-20 minutes of your time, but by doing this, you can collect quite a bit of shrouds, which will really help you out. Trust me, you're going to be very impressed, and you're going to be thankful that you did it now for later on. See, we got a 3-star battle rating, and that gave us a Fortisol. So the lower amount of stars, the greater your chances of obtaining shrouds. See, we got no stars for that, and that got us a Deceptisol. So yes, it does take a little bit of time, but this is nothing, you know. in terms of the rewards that you're going to get for it, because shrouds are very, very, very important in this game. And this is a very great spot to farm a couple of them early on in the game. So at the end of the battle, you can check and see how many shrouds you got by pressing the L1 button on PlayStation and left bumper on Xbox. I'd wait till you get about 5 of each. You know, you can get 10 if you want. The more, the better. Yeah, the more the better, but it's all up to you. You can just do a loop around the area. And then head back into the next area. Turn around. And bam, enter the previous area and all of the enemies are respawned. So that's going to conclude this episode of Final Fantasy 13. Go ahead and farm some shrouds so that you can use them in upcoming boss battles. And I'll see you guys next time on the next episode of Let's Play Final Fantasy 13.